and welcome to the beach.
Our raindrop is picking up speed now on its way back to the sea.
We're on the north end of a 2-mile-long sand spit at a place inside the Cascade Biosphere Reserve called Westwind.
Now, you didn't mean spit like saliva, right, Ava?
No, Alder. A spit is a narrow coastal land formation that is tied to the coast at one end, similar to a peninsula. Spits are usually created at the mouth of an estuary from the deposition of sand by a current on one side of the headland, just like this one.
Let us investigate further.
This sand spit helps to channel the river so it flows right up against the rocks of Cascade Head as it meets the sea.
Much of this sand is made from the weathering of rock that makes up this giant stony headland.
If you look closely, you'll see each grain of sand is a little different because they're broken off from larger rocks and pushed along down the watershed.
The river is at its widest point here, about 10 feet deep at high tide. It looks peaceful on the surface, but it's actually teeming with all kinds of creatures from the sea.
Scientists use what are called seine nets to capture and study all types of organisms that live here.
A seine net hangs vertically in the water. Its bottom edge is held down by weeds, and its top edge uses floats to keep it on the surface of the water.
They found a wide variety of sea creatures that come up the Salmon River to feed, including Chinook salmon, shrimp, jellyfish, and Dungeness crab.
Seine nets are used here because they don't harm the animals they catch, so they can be released after scientists complete their work.
What do you think it is?
Well, it looks like some kind of larvae, something like a nymph. And it looks like he personally made this husk. It looks like pieces of little bits of wood together, so it's definitely a defense mechanism.
See these fallen trees here, Eva? This is actual evidence of climate change.
These trees were actually pushed over by what are called high wave incidents.
These waves are unusually large and unpredictable, and they're dangerous because they can appear suddenly and without warning.
High wave incidents happen when temperatures rise in the southern Pacific Ocean near the equator. These temperature changes cause winds to increase in force and speed, pushing stronger and stronger waves across the sea, which can eventually roar into the mouth of the Salmon River.
It's common in winter and spring to see large curling breakers traveling well inside the spit. Over the past 10 years, this extreme wave action has eroded 75 feet of beach and toppled dozens of 30 to 40-year-old trees.
So climate change isn't just a saying here. To the people who live along the world's oceans, it's very real.
Climate scientists say this is just the beginning of many more climate-driven changes yet to come, particularly here along the West Coast.
Hey Alder, I can really hear the surf now. Should we head around the corner and see where the river finally meets the sea?
Hey-ho, hey-ho, to the beach we go. Hopefully the tide is low. Come on, we're going.